Hi, I'm Chris Lofthouse, and this is the time-aware calendar from ometistoolkit.com. The time-aware calendar generates a calendar script, as you might have guessed, which allows you to put it into the data load editor of your ClickSense applications, and it's highly optimized, uses best practices, and allows you to add some further functionality to your calendar scripts. To start with, you'll need to pass it a date field. Next, you can give it a name. I'm just gonna leave it as Ometis. And then you need to specify your first month of year. If you're using financial, it may be different to January. For example, you might use April or October as two other common alternatives. Next, we're going to provide some additional options. So here I'm going to populate any missing dates. This effectively backfills any dates I haven't transacted on or don't exist within my data set. You can also set the reference date. So here you can do it as today, or most commonly I would actually use max date. So if your date's not always current, it's not always got today's data in there, it just means it will use the max date within that data set. Equally, you can change the drill downs of any time-aware visualizations you might have. The default is going from year, month to date, but you might want to include in there quarter, week, and so on. And then next, and my most favorite functionality is the report period description. This provides descriptions to common date ranges that people might use within or when exploring their ClickSense data. So they'll have things such as like last quarter, current year to date, rolling 12 months, and so on. So I'm just gonna select all of those, and you can see on the right-hand side here, my script has been generated. If I had connected to my ClickSense site, I could push that to a particular application, or quite simply, I can copy it, navigate to my ClickSense app, paste that into the data load editor, and just click load data. With that loaded, we can now go to our sheet. Here, if I just expand the date calendar up, you can see we've got all the different date variations. So we've got some additional ones compared to the default calendar that the data manager provides. I'm just going to add that to my sheet. Just give a little space there. I'm also going to add the report description to the top as a filter pane. And then we'll add a measure to that visualization. Now, when we go into the view mode, you can see that we've got lots of different date ranges in here. So if I'm interested in a rolling 12 months, I can just scroll down here, set my rolling 12 months, and the view will flex accordingly. If I use bookmarks and bookmark that particular value, every time the app is refreshed, that bookmark will update to the most recent rolling 12 months. So I'm not having to, you know, create a new bookmark and then republish it and so on. Equally, you can also use a smart search now. If I just type in rolling 12 months, again, I can just press enter, and now I'm using natural language to make my date range selections rather than, again, having to select individual dates or weeks and so on. So that's the time-aware calendar. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll show you more next time.